stuff that's been happening. And I guess we're going into losers first.
Yeah, we are, because we got Best Nest sitting up against Zale, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, Zale beat Ape Man to get into top 16. So yeah.
He beat Ape Man and Fatality in his run to get here.
Oh, and I don't know who Best Nest beat. Oh, he beat Louis Money, or Luis, and I know he lost to Pandarian, and that's about it. That's all I know.
Apparently him and Pandarian have played like a bunch before this, too.
Huh?
Apparently him and Pandarian played a bunch before this.
Oh, okay. Happens.
Yeah.
Oh, and I know they were both at like... what's that tournament? I just remember it was when Stroder had that crazy grand final set.
Yeah.
Yeah. But anyway, so we're going into game one, Pokemon Trainer versus Ness. This doesn't seem like a fun matchup for Ness because of just how good Ivysaur is offstage.
I mean, Pandarian just kind of showed off when he beat Best Ness how crazy it is offstage.
Yeah.
The thing is, Best Ness doesn't really utilize... Best Ness doesn't really utilize the yo-yo very much.
Yeah.
And when Austin's utilizing the yo-yo, our local, you know, Ivysaur or Pokemon trainer Denti says that can kind of like invalidate the matchup. But when you don't bring that to the matchup,
I mean, you can also just kind of stall with your tether if you're Ivysaur, so it's not going to be the biggest deal. But Best Ness trying to make that Pika Thunder the biggest deal of the game so far, still going to make it back to the ledge. But we have Zale in advantage.
Okay, Zale uses a lot less. Oh god, just 0-for-3. However, still put on a lot of damage with those throw loops. And now you have Best Ness offstage.
That could have been really bad. Gonna miss the forward smash, but whiff, make Best Ness whiff the downer, which is nice.
And yeah, okay, that's gonna a be big punish. Just down smash, interesting.
I don't think you wanted to get greedy. He just said, you know what, I'm gonna hit him, it's fine.
Yeah. Just take the damage. Best Ness is at 125.
He just did it.
Okay. I expected like a pivot grab or something, put him off stage, back throw, that's what you want.
Yeah, he just did it.
Just forward smashing, that's fine.
Yeah. Okay, Best Ness gonna have to bring this back, but again, it's kind of hard for Ness, who doesn't have a lot of range, to get into the range of Ivysaur, especially if Ivysaur just wants to use that move. That back air can be so, so destructive.
Right. I mean, Ness has, you know, he's got some disjoints with his magical attacks, but it's not gonna contest with the vines.
Yeah. Down smash gonna be a little bit too slow, not gonna land its mark. So Zale has a little bit more life on this stock. Let's see if he can get a hit with Charizard, but if not, a low percent fight against the Squirtle is still gonna be pretty good for him.
There we go. I mean, we are so many hits away from Best Ness taking this back throw. Might even do it across stage. Yeah. Oh,
okay, wow. From across stage and Charizard super heavy.
Charizard's heavy.
That's a good back throw, ladies and gentlemen. Like, that's a good stuff. Oh, missed the downer. That was a huge conversion mess up right there.
Yeah, that downer actually has incredible stun for you to get sick, like other follow-ups and other stuff.
Oh, and yo, Best Ness trying to go ham. Kind of was, but only with 48% to show for, and that down throw nair going to basically bring up the deficit. That upper going to give Zale the lead back to the Razor Leaves.
Yeah, these Razor Leaves are kind of hard for Ness to deal with. Sometimes he can kind of clank with his hitboxes and he has the bat, but it's a big commit.
Yeah, and he's not like fast enough to just kind of like run, parry it, and then get like a bunch of position. But that, I love landing up air grab. By love, I mean hate.
Yeah. Mood. God.
Yeah, forward smash is going to get punished.
The creativity that Ness can have with drag downs is nuts, but being stuck on the platform, Ivysaur upper covers like the whole thing.
Yeah, basically, between up air or like up B, God forbid.
That
like,
change to Zard right there was really crucial, because otherwise that back throw was just it.
100%. And that back throw will be it, because way closer to the blast zone, so Best Ness now up 2 stocks to 1 after being down a pretty sizable amount first stock. Oh, and a PK Fire to start it off.
That's the day he was looking for. Quick 54?
Ness is busted.
Ness is busted. The people
don't
know.
What anyone says.
The people don't know.
Oh, dude, if he footstooled him off stage or something, that would have been a statement going into game two. Also,
honestly,
I guess this is the first best of five set we're going to see on stream, isn't it?
Yes. It sure is. And if anyone's going to go out there and like footstool the Pokemon trainer, I feel like Best Ness might be the one to do it. He has so much experience.
And also, he's just kind of a jerk when he plays. Like, in not a bad way.
Like the best kind of way.
The best Ness kind of way.
Yeah.
Oh, okay,
he definitely plays with his hat sideways.
But it's right now, this is going to be a super hard deficit for Zale to bring back. Because Ness is just so solid, hard to really, like, jank him out, I guess, unless you're going to get a spike with, like, Charizard or something, second stock. But he has to still deal with this stock. And I love that Best Ness goes for those Magnus off stage. It covers the double jump and then just puts you in such a bad position if you have a recovery that just doesn't instantly zip up.
He was just stalling in that range for so long, and Zale took a ton of time to recover.
Like, he did everything correct.
And still, there was nowhere to go. Eventually, he had to tether from as far as possible, and Best Ness was just there.
And the thing is, because he does that magnet, because if you get, like, sometimes you get hit, if you try to double jump into the Ness or, like, through him to try to recover, then the magnet just clips you out of your double jump, and then now you're just dead.
Yeah.
So I saw him do that a lot in doubles.
He'll just run off, hold that, and then he can combo into bear and air.
Yeah, it's insane. Nuts. Or again, just do that type of pressure and get a fair, like it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
And so Bestness going to play, have a really strong, after the kind of a mediocre first dog, really, really strong game one. Let's see Zale taking him to FD. Interesting.
I don't know. Normally I see Pokemon trainers loving like Smashville or characters. Yeah, characters with it, or stages where they can really take advantage of the platforms.
Yeah, so this is an interesting pick. Maybe Zale thinks it's more of a Squirtle matchup, and Squirtle does get some off the platforms, but at the same time, just want to play that neutral with the fair down tilts, or rather forward tilts.
It looks like a down tilt for sure.
Is he
dead? Oh, God.
Oh, my God, that was so good.
And it almost killed, too. Setting up for the back air there at the very edge of the stage off the magnet.
I love that confirm. That was so sick. And Bestness just actually going ham this game. Another magnet. Oh, he went for an upper because he's trying to be a jerk.
Yeah, I mean, he definitely could have confirmed into a back air there. But yeah, he decided he wanted to be cool.
I don't like giving Ivysaur the second chance, too. Like, Ivysaur is one of the most explosive characters in the entire game. But speaking of explosive, going to explode into that blast zone is Bestness. So, or rather, is Zale. So, yeah. Bestness with the one stock lead.
Stuck at this ledge, though. He's sitting at 95. He fights out so well.
He, as in Bestness or as in Ness, Bestness in general?
I mean, as Bestness. I mean, Ness does have some good tools, though. He's got boxing for days.
Yeah.
You don't want to box against Ness. Oh! But, you know, a Razor Leaf is fine. A Razor Leaf is fine.
Projectile kill confirms are nice.
Yeah.
100%. Oh, that Pika Fire barely whiffing. That would have been a lot of percent, some momentum for Bestness, but still has the momentum and the, you know, big percentage lead, in my opinion. Ooh, back air, ledge trapping, Ivysaur. Actually better than a lot of people think, just because I feel like Ivysaur's air mobility and ground speed are kind of slow.
Yeah.
She has to commit to things like up airs and down airs, so obviously she has the ability to switch into Charizard, which is obviously good.
Up throw? What are you doing?
It wasn't going to kill, so get that Pika Thunder damage.
Yeah, just set up the juggle. That's crazy. I don't see that often.
And he didn't stale the back throw, which is the smartest part about it, to make sure that back throw was going to kill. Bestness is kind of going off, and Texas right now in shambles.
Yeah. Bestness? Really showing off very high-level Ness play. Though down tilts?
See, like, that down air so good. So scared to go for the second one. But that magnet, again, like, just doing such a good job at almost covering that option.
Zale's really greedy right now.
Yeah, when you're down versus Ness, you feel like you have to close it out, and then suddenly you just get magnet stalled, and you feel like an idiot.
Yeah.
Happens.
He has control of center, though, but he keeps backing up. One fair took it all back.
Sometimes Bestness just plays like a jerk, and I love watching it. It's kind of scary, always dead, 100%. Oh, I lied,
wow.
99%. Whoops.
I mean, he definitely could have just, like, charged forward smash, but he was like, no, I want to do something cool.
And again, just getting these magnets.
The forward tilt backhand, oh my.
I don't know why that move kills.
That's dumb.
Yeah.
So, I taught my casual friend how to play Smash.
Uh-huh.
He played Ness. It was a match made in heaven.
Okay.
Because it's very simple for him.
Yeah.
And
except the recovery.
Yeah. That's how I learned that that move kills an ultimate. Is he would just hit forward tilt and I would die.
Yeah. My roommate plays Ness, and we were doing like a short hop magnet, double jump magnet, like drag down up arrow fair confirms, and he's like, yeah. And if you're all the way on the other side of the stage, you just do forward tilt, and I'm like, forward tilt forward kills, and it kills it like it kills Pika at like 115 at ledge. Yeah. I'm like, why?
It's actually stupidly strong, and no Smash 4 Ness player would have hit that button on purpose.
Except for Bestness.
Except for Bestness.
Yeah. Because Austin would have won like a minute ago by like random other stuff. No, I'm just joking. Bestness, I mean, he's the only Ness still in. I think Austin's out. So.
Yeah, it's possible. I haven't
I saw a tweet that was very upsetty.
Yeah.
So I assume that Bestness is the only one in.
I know he dropped to losers playing Dakpo.
Yeah.
So that was unfortunate.
Dakpo played really well.
Dakpo was insane.
Yeah. So game three, Bestness again up 2-0. Kind of styled on him. Again, after the first stock of game one, Bestness has been kind of doing whatever he wanted, and it's been working. So how will Zale quell this momentum? Like, what do you think he needs to do?
I mean, first of all, I like the stage pick way better.
Yeah, 100%.
Battlefield will help. But man, he is just dashing around too much, getting caught by these PK fires and getting hit by all these hitboxes. Evasive movement and not committing as much are really nice. Like, sit back and Razor Leaf if you have to.
Yeah, I mean, that was when he had the biggest success game one, so I don't necessarily disagree. Sometimes you just get flustered by Ness, and it's really unfortunate. Although, I feel like someone from Texas should be a little bit more experienced in the matchup. Granted, obviously, I'm pretty sure
Texas
regions.
Is huge. I don't know if Zale has ever played Austin.
Because he's Houston. Because I'm assuming he's Houston because he's SU.
He's Houston.
Oh, messing up the drop through upper. That's actually a really good kill confirm. For God, I hate that move.
Okay, that should be a kill. He just forward tilted. He was too scared.
I don't think he had enough time to do anything else, to be honest. But
maybe down smash? I don't know.
Maybe not.
Maybe just flare blitz in that direction.
That's a good option. Yeah. Flare blitz is underrated as a punish option. At 45, try to get a drag down. Magnets. Best Ness is hitting every button, and you know Zale's thinking, oh, God, please,
so much damage so quick.
Yeah. He's like, please stop hitting me. Please stop hitting me. And I don't blame him because he's kind of just getting run over right now, Zale.
Okay. For a second, I thought the explosion was the down air, and I was like, what the hell?
Same. 100%. Or I thought it traded for a second. So right now, Best Ness, you know, he's playing so well. The Pika Thunder to catch him on the ledge. The Fair to try
Such
to
Such a smart recovery from Zale.
Yeah, that was really, really good. Just go dropping all the way down.
No.
Fire Breath, Flamethrower, whatever it's called. I guess it's Flamethrower because it's a Pokemon move, right?
Right.
Just trying to space out with these F-Tilts, but going to get Pika fired. No type resistance in this game, unfortunately. So that's going to be full damage, full hit stun, and just do so much. And now a back throw will kill from most anywhere. That drag down upper going to be so safe. I think the upper is only like minus 5 on shield or something
like
that.
It's so good.
It's really dumb. Oh, speaking of really dumb, being able to walk the dog into the... The devs had interesting decisions when it came to Ness. And again, just already down... Pika fire down throw is already 27.8. About to lap Zale. This just looks like a body bag incoming.
Here comes Ivy, though. You know, Ivy's volatile. Ivy can make things happen. But it needs to be Zale's turn, right?
And I feel like Zale hasn't had a turn basically the whole game. I mean, Best Ness only really died when he overextended. Granted, he kind of is overextending.
Oh!
Extending the Vine Whip, too.
Yeah? Tell me more.
Oh, missing the down smash. Actually going to get stuffed out by that Nair. Fishing for a grab, of course. Every single Ivysaur, most of what they do is try to fish for grab. I mean, it's so much damage. Like, I don't blame them.
Up throw up air is like 30 damage.
Oh, he's dead.
Oh, trying the challenge.
We've seen it too many times, so we didn't even get hype about it. But
no,
man.
It's so normal now. Trying to challenge?
Why is it combo?
Trying to challenge it when you get hit by it, and then just suddenly you're stuck there, and there's nothing you can do. You can buffer air dodge as much as you want. You get clapped.
Yeah, and he was, like, at 120, which was obviously super overkill, but, like, that'll kill it, like, 50%, even from across stage, even on Battlefield, even maybe on Charizard. So that move, super strong.